Although it is a common movie flaw that action heroes never reload their guns, RoboCop can actually be seen reloading two times on screen.
You should get out of here now.
Hey, we're partners.
Get the car.
Once in the first movie, and another time in the second movie. After that, however, we never see it again in either RoboCop 3 or the two TV shows.
May I see your gun, please? Oh, thank you. Is it fully loaded?
Yes.
So now that we know he reloads, where does Robo actually keep the ammunition? Frank Miller, scriptwriter for RoboCop 2, played around with the idea of having ammo magazines in Robo's hand gauntlets that he could use to reload. Ultimately, this was never shown in the movie. However, the concept did appear in the comic adaptation of an early RoboCop 2 script published by Avatar Press. In the 1993 TV series, RoboCop's left leg was used to store a number of items, all of which would solve a specific problem in that episode.
RoboCop, do you have your isoflow?
Perhaps this would also be a good place to store additional ammo. In the 2001 TV series RoboCop Prime Directives, the writers went with the idea that Robo had onboard ammo supplies that feed his weapon directly through a slot in his hand. This high-tech solution is interesting, but in the finished product, none of that is actually shown or implied.
Nice shooting. Thank you.
Now, the gun twirl was used in the first movie, first and foremost, as a plot device. However, since then, it's become an integral part of RoboCop's personality.
Pretty fancy moves, Murphy.
The twirling became so synonymous with the character that it has appeared in everything from RoboCop comics...
The situation is now under control.
...to animated shows... ...to video games. In fact, both arcade games have the twirl at the end of each level.
Thank you for your cooperation.
Thank you for not smoking.
Twirling it was another matter altogether, although it was perfectly balanced. It's like trying to twirl half of a baseball bat. You know, it's an integral part of the old Robo personality, man, you know, to twirl that gun into a holster like a cowboy.
RoboCop twirls his gun in the first two movies, but never in RoboCop 3 or the 2014 remake. In the series, he can be seen doing a lazy version of the twirl in episodes Tin Man and Heartbreakers, and some kind of a super spin in the episode Provision 22. In RoboCop Prime Directives, the writers originally did not want to include the twirl at all, since it was linked to Murphy's son and being a role model to him. In the Prime Directive series, James Murphy is now grown up, and the writers felt that the twirling had now lost its purpose.
Yeah, well, role models can be very important to a boy.
215 Third Palm. This is the Gans Pharmaceutical Company online.
Okay, I get a kick out of it.
In the four-parter, the twirl can be seen at the very end of the last episode via a reused clip from the 1993 TV series.
Still patrolling the streets, he had this to say to the grateful citizens of Delta City.
Stay out of trouble.
If OCP just wanted a robot, why the hell did they put Murphy in there in the first place?
Murphy's dead, sweetheart. That's on record.
I am Officer Alex Murphy. Detroit Police Department.